Howdy there, folks, and welcome into today's video. Thank you so much for joining me. As always, for the last couple hours, I've been sifting through stocks, and I found five stocks that are making people millionaires in the stock market right now. These five stocks have been going absolute beast mode. We're going to take a little look at these stocks. We're going to try to figure out, are these stocks that are worth looking into at all? Have they already made their big runs and they're over, or are these just getting started? Some of these stocks you guys have probably never heard of in your life. Some of them you're gonna definitely heard of before. So hope you guys enjoy this video. Let me know if you enjoy a video like this where we get into some stocks that are huge movers to the upside or downside. I could always do a video like five stocks that are getting absolutely devastated in the future. If you guys are ever interested in something like that, we could do that as well, kind of looking at like five stocks that are maybe down 50% plus or something like that. These stocks are all up hundreds of percent, if not 1,000% plus just this year. We're talking just year to date, okay? These five I've found are just massive movers. So I hope you guys enjoy this. As always, all I ask in return is that you smash that like button. And that is literally it. Guys, I appreciate you being here as always. If you want to check out the Hungry Bull, we are now on iOS and Android store. I believe dark mode is actually coming tonight. So that is, I'm super excited about that. And I'm sure a lot of you guys are as well. Way to track the markets, what's going on with that. Read our daily newsletter, as well as track your stocks, listen to earnings calls, keep up with news, look at financials, do a little research, stuff like that. Let's get into this, guys. A fifth stock of these five that I found here. Look at this one, okay? You know we're going to have a banger list when the fifth best stock on the list is up 245%. I've never heard of this company in my life, I don't believe, okay? Technoglass Inc., TGLS. It's a $22 stock here today. It was actually down 3% here today, but it's up 245% year to date. It's made a massive move upward. If I look at just the key stats right off the bat here, it at least has me a little intrigued. Look at the PE, look at the forward PE. Okay. Market cap's $1 billion. You guys know I love the kind of, you know, $1 billion to $5 billion type companies, especially recently. So, might have something here. Technoglass is a holding company which enables design, manufacturing, distribution, marketing, and installation of specific architectural glass windows products for the construction industry. And we know construction has been pretty decent, especially in residential recently. And we also know when it comes to commercial construction, that usually does good when money is cheap, right? When you can borrow money. And guess what? We're definitely in one of those time periods right now. The firm is a manufacturer of architectural glass and windows for the Western Hemisphere residential and commercial construction industries. The company manufactures a range of glass products, including primarily commercial and residential buildings, including tempered safety, double thermal acoustic, and laminated glass. Its products are installed in hotels, residential buildings, commercial and corporate centers, universities, airports, hospitals, and a wide range of basically other facilities. Okay, so yeah, it actually seems like a pretty darn interesting company. Need to say, this is when I read through a profile like that, this is something I can wrap my head around right off the bat, and I'm at least interested in this one. Okay, now here's the other thing. We look at the PE. PE's at 19.9. Forward PE's less. I'd love to see a trailing 12-month PE that is higher than the forward PE, because essentially, if you see a trailing 12-month PE higher than a forward PE, what that means is that the company is expected to get more profitable in the upcoming year than they were in the last year. That's something I definitely look at as a positive. Price to sales ratio 2.3 does not seem crazy at all. Obviously, the stock's made a massive run, but I gotta say, this one actually has me a little intrigued, and I hate to ever buy a stock that is up huge. You guys know me. I like to usually buy the stocks that are beaten down dog stocks, right? This one's been flying high, but I got to say, I got to listen to a few earnings calls of them, see what's going on here in the business model. Maybe this is just the start of a much, much bigger run for this company, or maybe this is a tapped out situation. So I got to look a little more in depth in the fundamentals of this company, getting those earnings calls, but it definitely has me intrigued, guys. So there was a fifth stock up here of the bunch. Let's get in that fourth stock of these five that are making people absolutely a fortune, and that is Dillard's, DDS. Look at this one, 252% gain year to date. I mean, look at the chart this year, like boom, like somebody, it just went up like a rocket ship. It's like a SpaceX, okay? Bezos is somewhere on that flying up. My gosh, guys. What a move for Dillard's to be, you know, performing like that's amazing, okay? Now, me personally, I'm not interested in this stock. It really doesn't matter the valuation. It doesn't matter really how much the stock goes up or down. I'm just not a big believer in their business model. They're a department store that kind of tries to cater to the general mass, and I just don't like that particular business model. So it really doesn't matter what the valuation is trading at for Dillard's. I'm pretty much not interested in this stock, and especially after it made a huge run. Also, not interested, you know, from a perspective of, look at the PE. The PE is actually much, much lower than a forward PE. That's definitely not something I ever like to see. I want to see a reverse of that, right? And so that's not good. I don't like the business model overall. Yeah, it's trading at a fairly cheap price to sales ratio of 0.76, but also do keep in mind it's a department store. They generally always trade under one price to sales ratio. So yeah, Dillard's does not have me intrigued at all, to be completely honest, okay? Now, the only stock I own in this space is Nordstrom, JWN, and this stock has been performing amazing, except for today. Today got, you know, slammed. But here's the thing when it comes to Nordstrom, right? This is a company that just reported actually really good earnings. If you look at those earnings, they were actually impressive. And that stock just got slapped 17%. You know, there's a big difference in Nordstrom and in Dillard's, I can tell you that. And Nordstrom is like up here compared to Dillard's is like right here, right? And I mean, if Dillard's has any type of troubling numbers, what do you think that stock's going to be down in a given day? You know, if Nordstrom can get slapped like this, you ain't seen nothing compared to what could happen to potentially to Dillard's in this situation, right? So yeah, that's kind of my two cents there. Nordstrom's been a huge moneymaker for us. I'm not looking to get rid of that stock even after today's move or anything like that. At the end of the day, that's a profit machine. That's a company that should have years and years of decent growth in front of them. This is not a high growth company, and it's also a dividend company, and they compete at the high end of the market, which is where I'd want to compete if I'm in this space, not like a Dillard's that's just trying to sell against everybody else. That's a tough, tough dang business model, okay? So yeah, Dillard's was our fourth one up here. Not a stock that's interesting to me. Let's get in number three, guys. Number three up here, the bunch. Probably never heard of this company before. Veritev Corp. VRTV on this one. $83 stock here today. Over 300% gainer year to date. 304%. Look at that stock chart this year, guys. Boom! My gosh, what a massive move for this company up here, right? Now, if we just look at the key stats, I can already tell you there's something I'm a little worried about. PE, 13.8, forward PE, 25. You know, not to say that's the end of the world for this company, but it's going to be something that is at least interesting to me. That price to sales ratio, what? A 0.19? You almost never see something that low. That seems insane. Market cap, 1.2 billion. What the heck does this company do? Veritev Corp engages in business-to-business distribution of print publishing packaging facility solutions, print and publishing products and services. Company's headquartered in Atlanta, has over 6,000 employees. Company went IPO back in 2014. The firm also provides logistic and supply chain management solutions to its customers. The firm segments are print publishing, print and management, packaging facility solutions, and corporate and other. The print segment sells and distributes commercial printing, writing, copying, digital, wide format and specialty paper products, graphic consumables, and graphics equipments. The publishing segment sells and distributes coated and uncoated commercial printing papers. The packaging segment provides standard as well as custom packaging solutions. So, I mean, it seems somewhat interesting here. I will say when it comes to this one, I need to understand on a little higher level. The facility solution segment sources and sells cleaning, break room, and other supplies such as towels, tissues, wipes, and, dispensers, things like that, trash liners. So not a rocket science business model. I think the biggest takeaway from this stock here is you don't have to be in the most complex of business models to make a whole bunch of money in the stock market. If you read through this company's description of their company, this is not a rocket science business model. I mean, I think just about anybody could spend 1 to 2 hours on this company, read through their 10K, and have a pretty darn good understanding of how this company makes money, what their opportunity is, what their challengers are, what their competitors are. I don't think, you know, this is not a complicated business model, and the year-to-date gain on this stock is over 300%. So I show this to people. I think this is a really, really important stock because You don't have to always find the next Tesla. You don't have to invest in some space company or something crazy to get a ridiculous gain on a stock. I mean, the 52-week low on the stock was, what, $10 or something? It's $80. That's an 800% gain in, like, you know, a very dang quick amount of time. The year-to-date gain for the stock is over 300%. So I show this to you guys so you can just understand there's some huge opportunities you can take advantage of in the market, and it doesn't have to be some complex, super crazy company that no one understands anything dang about, okay? This one I'm actually pretty intrigued at. Now, I'm not intrigued from this perspective. I'm going to have to look further into it. This is not intriguing to me, the PE basically being much higher next year than it is now. That's a little worrisome, but this, look at this. You know, you would think after that crazy run, this stock must have some crazy price-to-sales ratio. Heck no. Price-to-sales ratio of 0.19? You almost never see price-to-sales ratios of under 0.3. That's crazy. Even under 0.5 is nuts, right? Under 1 is considered very, very low price-to-sales ratio. But a 0.19? Like, what? Okay? That's just nuts, man. But once again, you don't have to be a rocket scientist or be in the most complicated business models to make some ridiculous money from the stock market. This company is the best dang example of that. And honestly, all three of these companies we've gone through so far, none of them are super hard to understand. Dillard's is a department store, okay? Look at the gains on that one. This company is a business-to-business seller of different, you know, materials as well as, you know, break room supplies and stuff like that. Not a super complicated business model. And the first one was a window company that had other different products that were in relation to glass and windows, right? I mean, these aren't like, oh my gosh, this is great. Like, and look at the gains, guys. So just keep this in mind. You don't need to always search for the most confusing stock to make some dang money. I'm going to have to listen to conference calls of this company, no doubt about it. I'm going to have to listen to some earnings calls of this one and see if maybe there's some opportunity here or maybe this one's done, okay? After those earnings calls, I'll probably have a good, pretty good understanding. All right, let's get to this second best stock of these five stocks up here, and that is ticker symbol BTU, Peabody Energy Corporation. 386% gain on this stock year to date. Massive move, not a massive market cap on this one at all, okay? Peabody Energy Corporation engaged in the business of coal mining. The company is I'm lost. I'm done. Okay, coal mining. It's a mining company in general. Nah, you're not. Okay. not my cup of tea. Respect if you want to own a coal mining company or a mining company in general. Just not for me, okay? Not for me at all. The mining companies, especially coal miners, just not an industry I'm interested in being in. It usually doesn't matter the valuation. Also, some other troubling things is no PE on the stock. The forward PE is not there right now. Maybe that's wrong. Maybe there will be a forward PE over time. We'll have to see. I mean, sometimes these mining stocks can be interesting to get in if they are super beaten down. Look at this one. It's supposedly 52-week low, and this one's 80 cents. 80 cents, okay? I mean, you know, mining companies are very commoditized businesses, okay? And commoditized businesses are, generally speaking, not great companies to hold long term. They are more companies for the day traders or specifically swing traders. I'm not a day trader. I'm not a swing trader. This is why a company like this does not interest me. I'm usually looking out to invest in stock over the next 3-5 years. Peabody, and usually if I'm looking any shorter time frame than that, then I usually get bitten, okay? Peabody Energy or mining companies in general, those are companies that are for the swing traders or the day traders, not for people like myself, okay? And respect, if you want to swing a mining company for a 6-month time frame, 12 month, you know, that is, do you, okay? Me, that's not me. That's why I'm not interested in a stock like this at all, okay? A stock like this is not even remotely intriguing to me, okay? Now, let's get into the best gainers of the bunch. I lumped these two stocks together here because they kind of, they're 1A and 1B, all right? GameStop, look at this one, over 1,000% gain year to date. And then we have AMC with a 2,000% gain year to date on these stocks. Now, obviously, when it comes to AMC and when it comes to GameStop, these stocks benefited from, the virality of these stocks, right? I mean, these went crazy on social media, Wall Street Bets everywhere. They became movements in themselves. Let's try to beat the hedge funds and things like that, right? And You know, as a long-term investor, neither of these stocks is intriguing to me as a long-term investment proposition when I look at the market caps versus where these stocks are at. However, this is kind of like the mining plays in the respect that I understand if people wanted to try to swing these, day trade these or something like that. That's not something I'm at all interested in or what I want to spend my time doing. However, there's no denying the fact that, you know, sometimes if you can play these on the right side, they can be money makers. It's just not something that's interesting to me. At all, to be completely honest. As far as a valuation proposition, it was very, very interesting in the past. I put out this video toward the beginning of the year when AMC was about $5. And at that time, I think maybe AMC was $5.50 at that time when I put out that video. At that time, AMC was definitely very, very interesting as a value proposition and as a stock that could make a move up to 20, maybe even over $20 a share. And it did that, and it did even more. Now, as a value proposition for somebody like myself that's a long-term investor, AMC is not interesting. However, I could definitely understand a lot of folks still wanting to play it from a trading perspective and things like that. That's just not my cup of tea. That's not what I do. And I can tell you, if I tried to do that, I would get my hat would flip off. Okay, that's all I'll say about that, because that's not my specialty at all. You got to kind of like stay in your lane. My lane's long-term investing. That's where I have the great success. You know, trying to get in a stock this week and then get out the next week. That's not my game, man. That's not even worth my time. So, anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this as always. I think there's a lot of money to always be made in the stock market, and it doesn't always have to be in the most complicated stocks. I can promise you that. If you're looking to be coached by one of our stock market millionaire coaches, check out and apply for the coaching right down there. That'll be the pinned comment. Just so you know, those spots are extremely limited. Much love as always, guys, and have a great day.